Hello there and welcome back to Strategic Command World War II, World at War, as we continue our fight to the last bullet to save France. And as I've loaded the save, I've noticed that I've forgotten to do two things. First of all, the German sub that have escaped, let's search for it possibly. I'm not sure where did it go? Not really. Alright. And of course a Russian track. Also, as you can see, those paratroopers in this hex south of Frankfurt, they are in range of my HQ and air fighters as well, so I'm going to switch things a little bit in here. I'm going to move my HQ to this hex for now. My air fighters will move there, my bomber will move here, and my heavy bomber will move to Caen. And I'm going to put, you can't put him right now, we're going to put this garrison in Chalon. Or you know what, I'm going to put this corp in Chalon, and this garrison in Paris. And hopefully we'll be able to move a Lyon garrison to Dijon or not. Okay, we'll move him back next turn. Alright, let's hit the end turn button and see what happens next turn. Which may be the turn, actually. The turn. Not. Let's hope that maybe it won't be, actually. Yeah, we've conquered the National Morale Objective City. Yes, they should. For their incompetence. Nice. Alright. That's nice, potentially. All right, let's see what happens. Is it the time? Is it the time? Calculating supply. The weather is very nice, which means war is happening in April. Wow. You finally appeared. So they have decided to attack one turn earlier than historically. Well, we'll see if we'll be able to defend France, even despite this, and Belgium as well. Oh, I see that the desperation mode is on for Japanese. They might get a few better terms, as it's spring, so they will be able to use their carriers and bombers, but you can see just a tiny bit here. If they leave this bomber in this position exactly, well, they won't have any more bombers on land, at least, as we already destroyed their medium bomber, and this is a tactical bomber. And of course, the units in Canton will be destroyed this turn. Yeah, you move. Alright, let's see what they'll be able to do. Really? It was a great attack for them. Not so successful for us, though. They've taken some damage from the AA gun. Really, he's gone then. If you want to play well, don't do that. They use their bombers, most of them, on French units. Will they have enough to take over Low Countries? Who knows? Probably yes, but there is always a chance. The problem with the defense of Low Countries, even if they survive the first turn, is that they use French MPPs to recover strength, which is not optimal, to say the least. Not very surprising. Well, they are actually a lot lucky with weather. I usually got like a muddy one and rainy one in April. Well, when I play Axis sometimes, of course. But usually I got a bad one this time around. Really? Yeah, that is what I was afraid of. As all those losses go towards French national morale. You keep trying, buddy. That's just pathetic. That's actually nice, as they will not drop behind our lines then, at least for now, but they've got another unit waiting somewhere. They will attack Brussels, I believe. Yep. Alright, then we... Yeah, that was... whatever it was, actually. It wasn't a good move, so low countries will not fall this turn. The question is, what do we do about it? They actually moved him. Kudos to you, AI. Not that amazing attack. And this earlier a bit attack will fasten the Italian introduction to this war, which means we'll have to be a bit faster. But our French income this turn should be actually pretty good with this this mine in our hands and both capitals as well as port, this huge port. Yeah. I would love to see like a garrison for Luxembourg, like at 2 strength maybe. Well, that wouldn't do much of a difference, but it would also be nice for Axis to waste one attack on this unit. Yeah, not really surprising there, and Norway as well. Yeah. Nice extra MPPs to the USA. I'm not really sure why it took the declaration of war sound, as it was not really an invasion. Narvik. Yep. Yes, we do. Yes, you did. But you wouldn't last long, actually. Calculating supply. Okay, we're in. Yeah, a lot of losses. We know all of that. Yes, we are going to prepare ourselves with home guard and a bit of morale is never bad. And you, my friend, you'll go to the south. Yeah, we'll deploy those. We have to deploy you in Los Angeles, so we are going to move this carrier to San Jose. And you're going to land in port. So, let's take a look at French morale. As I said, all those losses in Netherlands and Belgium came into their account, which is bad, to be honest, but let's start with China as we do usually, and let's take a look at them. As you can see, they have zero supply, which means exactly that. So, who's attached and who is not? Let's kill some stuff, shall we? Maybe let's take Canton for sure this turn, as we can deal with this army later on. Nice. Let's swap you. Beautiful. And let's advance. Move him. Let's do what we usually do without success. So who can still attack? You. Wow, one damage actually. And we're going to attack with you. And he's gone next turn. And we'll be free to advance north toward Shanghai, possibly. And we will attempt to cut those units off. Look at this. They just can't do anything. Another army should go to our account. Are you attached, my friend? Yeah. Beautiful. Oh my dear lord. Yet again the same thing. I'm not sure he was attached, actually. Which is not very nice. But I would love to move him, but we need some. We need to spend some MPPs on him first, I guess. You're not doing too great, my friend. Yeah, we're going to move back for now. We don't have enough forces to push north here, but we will hold for in Xingen. Right, let's start. We'll hit you. Nice. And you as well. And we'll swap with you. To deal some damage. Nice. Oh, I hoped for more. Well, have to deal with what we have. Who knows, maybe we'll be lucky. Not really, it seems, but next turn. So we will attempt to sandwich this entire sector from the north and from the south soon. Let's take a look. Can we deal some damage? He's got a bit too much experience for my own taste, so let's hurt him. Oh, and he entered the kill zone, which is not good for him. Let's take a look at research Chinese. We'll have it next turn, which is nice. And we'll invest another cheat into command and control. And you, my friend, will go to work. that's it. How much can we spend? Yeah, we're going to do it. And let's take a look at India now. We're not rich enough to buy HQ this turn, so we are going to... upgrade the two corp units that we have. Really, we don't have... oh, we don't have it yet. Alright then. And we won't upgrade them. And you'll join him next turn. That's, I believe that's this. It for this section. Let's take a look at Russia. That far, a bit more further. And let's take a look into Europe. Where are our tanks? Here. So we are going to sit on the front line. Directly. Alright. And you, we move you here. And of course, the United States. Let's do it. And the main prize. So, now we face a problem. Do we invest into the low countries or not? Of course, Netherlands is gone. The question is, do we want to give them these national moral points or not? I'm going to say not really. But we don't have much choice in this matter. So the question, other question is, do we reinforce those units or do we reinforce French units? And the other option is, do we advance in? And the question is no. Of course, you can say, well, we can secure the line in here, but we would lose all of the entrenchment and would be destroyed anyway. Way quicker, and we won't hold into Lille for long, which means that we will have less units on the front line. Limits as to buy one, as we have three in this section and we have two in this section, and we would have two in this position as well. And no, we are not going to do that. And the only question is, do we reinforce with French MPPs? As you can see, it's 100 MPPs for someone who will die this next turn anyway, so I'm going to say invest in the future, not now. We're going to move back to Lyon. You're not done yet. Need to definitely reinforce our armies by match points. Let's take a look. 6. How much would we need to spend on him? Let's reinforce you to 9. And we'll reinforce you, not you, you to 9 as well. And we still got some points left, so I'm going to maybe you for now. They have nothing to drop. They have they don't have anyone to drop behind our lines for now, as this paratrooper is adjacent to our units and he can do it. And this paratrooper is way too far. So that will be it for the French this turn. Let's take a look at diplomacy and Italian. Yeah, they will take, like, I believe, maybe even 2 turns, 2 hour turns, or one at least, but maybe even 2. So, who do we need to upgrade, definitely? You are going away from this. I would love to reinforce him. And it's time. His sub is there, so we are going to move our destroyers. And it's time to switch, or shall we say, replace our HQs. You will be replaced, and you will be replaced as well. We can't, why not? Ah, of course. Alexander, and we'll upgrade you. And Discord as well. Let's take a look at our destroyers. Let's rush them back, at least this one, as he needs to be fully reinforced. And this guy is going to port to resupply. We don't have any points left. Can we actually escape? Not really. Yes, he's working okay. No need to upgrade these ships next time, I guess, but that will be it for this turn. So, as usually, thank you for watching, and I hope that you like it, and I'll see you next time.